Clutch ini ada Martin sama Justin lagi datang nih. Kebetulan janjian hari ini gue minta dibantu check-in. Kemarin clutch kita yang udah kita kepasang, gue berasa ada bunyi-bunyi sedikit, tapi kata mereka, mereka pas kebenaran lagi mau ke Jakarta, jadi ya gue turunin gearbox-nya juga. Sekarang kita buka, kita assess dalamnya gimana nih, bagus nggak apa nggak. Mudah-mudahan semuanya aman, ntar kita ngobrol-ngobrol bareng mereka. Oke, okay, guys, sekarang kita di sini udah bersama dengan Justin dari Uniclutch. Oke, okay, hi Justin.
Hey.
Welcome to Jakarta. I'm glad you come today because normally we wouldn't disassemble a clutch, a good working clutch, and then because usually Uniclutch is really easy to install, right?
This is one of the big advantages is that mm-hmm. it's fully assembled, so you mm-hmm. wouldn't need to do this mm-hmm. normally. This is what actually a normal twin plate would be,
yeah,
that
yeah.
it's all individual components, but yeah. in the case of Uniclutch, you don't need to do that normally. So mm-hmm. this is kind of a rare occasion that we have of breaking it down and seeing what it looks like inside.
Right, right, for the video, yeah.
Yeah, for the video, yeah.
Oke, okay, jadi biasanya sih nggak perlu sampai dibongkar, tapi kali ini memang biar videonya bagus dan juga kalian bisa ngerti mengenai koplingnya Uniclutch, kelebihan apa, jadi hari ini kita bongkar dan kita ngobrol langsung sama Justin biar kita bisa tahu nih isinya apa. Oke, okay, so Justin, from what we see here,
yep.
does everything looks good? Everything looks normal?
Something like this is kind of normal that we would expect after maybe the bed-in period. Mm-hmm. So we see a little bit of wear going on here.
Yeah.
And we see when we have a look at some of the steel components, we see that we have some wear going on there.
Mm-hmm,
it's
mm-hmm.
perfectly normal for a clutch that's done some work
mm-hmm,
already.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing out of the ordinary of what right. we're looking at.
Okay, that's good. Then this is the first clutch, yeah?
So this is what we actually call it a secondary plate.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
It sits on top of the primary plate. And so mm-hmm. this is one of the two clutch discs that you have inside a Uniclutch.
Okay, so they have two clutch.
That's
this is
right.
the first one plate. And yeah. then after this, we lift this up. Ah, yeah, we'll
and
find
we
the
have
other
the second,
one.
Yeah,
yeah. yeah.
So why would you have like a twin plate?
Mm-hmm,
this
mm-hmm.
is all about surface area. So what we're trying to do is mm-hmm. to have mm-hmm. more surface area and
yep.
essentially trying to make the clutch seem bigger than what it is.
Okay. Jadi ini yang disebut dengan twin plate. Jadi biasanya kalau kampas kopling, so the normal one usually like organic full pads on
That's
it, right?
That's right. Yeah. So what mm-hmm. would have come off this car would have been a full organic,
mm-hmm.
And the size of it would have been a little bit larger.
Bigger. Oh yeah. Actually, we do have
oh,
it there.
Have it. Yeah,
later,
yeah.
we'll show it to the camera.
Oh, great.
And then the stock one is full rounded and
yeah.
all pads. And then they will put in on the top of it. They have a cover, right?
Yes, that's
okay,
right.
That's
it would have
a normal
disc
one,
and then one cover that goes over,
mm-hmm.
and that cover bolts to then your flywheel.
Okay, that's what we call a normal.
It's normal sort of clutch
yeah.
setup is something
okay.
like that. Yeah.
Jadi biasanya kalau untuk yang standar ya, standar itu koplingnya itu cuma ada satu plat kampas dan di atasnya itu ada cover. Cover tuh yang seperti ini. Ya, jadi ada kayak kukunya, dia akan neken biar kampasnya ini. Tapi yang ini kita sebut dengan twin plate. Kenapa twin plate? Karena kita ada dua kampas kopling. Jadi yang satu di sini nih, ini agak berat. Ini satu kampas, di atasnya kampas, ditaruhlah yang namanya, this is what we call a cover, right?
This
cover.
Is actually, it's called an intermediate plate.
Oh, intermediate plate.
Steel
plate.
So that sits between, yeah, and it basically, it's kind of like having another pressure plate in
mm-hmm,
there,
mm-hmm.
and it sits between the clutch discs.
Okay, so this is like the, you know, like a hamburger, this is called the the
so
meat.
The people in the US, they uh-huh. call that the sandwich plate or the floater plate
right.
sometimes, but
okay,
we call it an intermediate plate. But yeah, it's
the cheese, basically.
You could actually think of it as another bun inside of it, three pieces of
we got
bread.
A double cheeseburger.
Yeah, know. That's right. The bottom of the bun is
uh-huh.
here.
Uh-huh.
We've got another bun that we add to
mm-hmm,
it in
mm-hmm.
here, and then we have
the
top bun over there.
Okay,
and this is
okay.
our fillings that is there. So we've got some beef down the bottom here.
Right.
Maybe we have some lettuce. We're healthy, and we have lettuce here.
What a way to describe a clutch. Okay.
First time of ever describing.
Yeah. So, jadi inilah konstruksi apa twin plate tadi kita gambarkan dengan seperti hamburger ya. Jadi yang bagian bawah itu kita bilang ibaratnya kayak rotinya, di atas itu ada daging, terus tengah-tengahnya ini roti lagi, daging lagi, dan baru terakhir ditutup dengan cover. Jadi inilah kurang lebih insinya dari Uniclutch, tapi yang membedakan mereka itu adalah mereka punya flywheel itu nggak menggunakan yang orinya. Jadi mereka itu akan duduk di bagian ini ya, di bagian bawah ini nih, ini adalah pengganti flywheel dari mobil ori. Oke, okay, so I told to our viewers that Uniclutch is unique because we don't have to replace all the flywheel, right?
Yes, that's right.
The stock flywheel, even the, if you have some damage to the flywheel, you can reuse it.
Doesn't matter. As long as we can bolt to it, that's all we care about, because the Uniclutch itself has that flywheel friction surface built into it.
Let us show to the camera again. So this is what makes Uniclutch unique. Even though you already have warp
flywheel doesn't matter. The flywheel doesn't matter. Yeah,
because you guys already include. This is the This is the flywheel size.
So that we can see that that bottom clutch, your primary clutch disc, has been wearing on here.
Oh, okay.
And we see a little bit of heat marks here. Nothing massive. And the surface itself looks really good. This is then replacing the flywheel friction surface.
All right. So this thing also will have some lifetime for it, right?
Yeah. Well, the advantage that you get with this is that, you know, you're leaving the flywheel on the car. You're not taking that off because you don't need to get that re-machined and resurfaced. We're just bolting directly to it. So the advantage is that you don't need to replace the bolts on the flywheel, anything like that. Keep the flywheel on there and you bolt then the Uniclutch to it.
Okay, so when the things wear out, we just need to change
The clutch core itself. You can actually keep the fitment kit, providing everything looks fine and no damage to it. You could actually keep that and you're replacing a clutch pack.
Okay,
so and replacing then, this is a fully assembled unit, no messing around. Don't have to worry about torquing up the bolts to a certain spec or anything like that with this clutch. The clutch is all ready to go. All we need to do is add the fitment kit to it.
All right, that's cool. So that makes the Uniclutch is unique because we don't have to stock every installation kit for each car.
That's right,
we just buy the whole thing and then when you want to change it to another car, just buy the bracket.
Well, this particular fitment kit that you have here, so this is a 275 fitment kit, which also fits like a GR Yaris or GR Corolla.
Oh, really? Oh,
it fits loads of other things as well. So it not only fits your car, but if you had another car coming in and you only had this one fitment kit, it could actually fit a lot of other cars.
All right. So next time I'm changing the car into GR Yaris, I'll put the clutch away.
You can use your fitment kit. Take out your clutch.
Yeah, that's really cool. That's cool. Okay, so after this, we want to clean everything and make sure we install it the right way.
Yeah, so that's right. So after this, usually we wouldn't be taking apart the clutch at all. So in this particular case, under my supervision, we will be reassembling the clutch.
Please. That is why I need you to come here.
So what we'll do is we will reassemble, torque everything down correctly, and we'll actually do another check because usually in the factory, we have a robot that checks this, but I'm the robot.
All right.
So we're going to recheck the fingers. So the fingers on the diaphragm.
This is the finger there, right?
And we're going to recheck that they're all the correct height as
All right, all right. Now, usually, looks okay to me.
Yeah, well, when it's bolted down, this will come to a different height.
Ah, okay, because there's a tension.
Of that tension, that's going to bring those fingers down. And what we need to make sure is when we're doing something like this, which ordinarily we would be doing in a factory with a robotic checker, but because we're doing it, we're going to check all these same factors that we would normally check.
Okay. I hope everything looks good and going
well. If we do
a bad
job of reassembling it, we will then get a new unit, but let's see if the budget robot of Justin is better.
Okay, thank you so much, Justin, for your explanation.
No problem, thank you for having me.
Thank you. Okay, guys, ini sudah terpasang lagi semua. Akhirnya sudah bulat berkat Justin. So Justin has helped us to assemble again. So everything okay, yeah?
So we had a look at all the components. They all look good. Sort of normal amount of wear that we'd expect from this bed-in period.
Yeah.
So the clutch is looking great at this stage. So then we've reassembled it, torqued everything down correctly. Again, we wouldn't do this normally. We wouldn't say to our customers to do this, but because I know what I'm doing with this, I could do this. Reassembled everything, checked everything as well. We checked your finger height, that they were nice and even.
Yeah.
This means that everything was then torqued down correctly, and now it's ready to go back into
your car. As good as new.
As good as new back in there. Okay. You've done your bedding in for that, so you're ready to go. You can put that back onto the car.
All right.
And make sure you bleed all your hydraulic system, and then we're good to go again.
Okay, with that to go, so this will be fitted back into the car, and I'll put some more boost to
test it. Yeah, for some more tests. You haven't got it to slip yet, right? Yeah,
not yet.
So yeah, we want to put some more
tests
to it.
Yeah,
more power.
All right, so this car will be going to Mandalika as well.
Okay, great.
In July, we have a time attack again with the Subaru and this car as well.
All right, if I'm allowed to go, I will.
You should come. Okay, thank you so much for
Excellent.
Your time.
Excellent. Hey, thanks for having me. Really appreciate it.
Without you, maybe we'll ruin the clutch and then bye-bye.
Yeah, well, look, it's going well so far. I'm glad to hear that you're enjoying it in the car and it's feeling
so nice in the car.
So, like, happy days. Enjoy your driving then enjoy that clutch.
Yeah, I hope so. I hope everyone also trust the clutch, yeah, because I already try in my car as well, in the Type R, the latest Type R, not the old one.
Mm-hmm.
So I think will be really great for the earlier type to use this kind of clutch, yeah, because it's really lightweight and also hold the torque well and then drivable.
Smooth to drive, like stuck in Jakarta traffic, it's still fine.
You saw the traffic.
Yeah, I saw the traffic. And it's still easy to shift for you and holding all that torque that you're going to, and more torque that you're going to put through this soon.
That's the best thing about the Uniclutch. All right.
All right, great.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks,
mate. Thank you.